The fear of the Lord enables us to have an excellent spirit. Job chapter 1 in verse 1, there was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job, and that man was blameless and upright, and one who feared God and shunned evil. Job was able to discern between good and evil. We read the same thing about Jesus. Jesus knew what was right and what was wrong, what was good and evil, and Jesus loved what was good and he hated what is evil, which is why God gave him the name above every other name, which is the mighty name of Jesus. So God is pleased with those who fear him. The other example is that of Daniel. Now, Daniel too had a similar heart attitude. You know, he loved what was right and he stayed away from what was wrong. And above all, he lived a life of worship before God. Even though he was in a foreign land, he was in Babylon, his life of reverence towards the Lord was evident to everybody. Let's just read of, you know, what, how Daniel was perceived among these foreigners and you know, in his workplace. Daniel 6 and 3. Then this Daniel distinguished himself above the governors and satraps because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought to setting him over the whole realm. What made Daniel distinguished? What separated Daniel? What caused him to stand out? The fear of the Lord in his heart. You know, as Daniel lived such a life unto the Lord and towards the Lord, even his governors, even those who were over him, looked at him with favor. And you read that they also saw an excellent spirit in Daniel. And you read about, you know, Daniel performing well in everything, being good in everything. So Daniel 1:20, and in all matters of wisdom and understanding above, about which the king examined them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers who were in all his realm. So obviously, you know, Daniel exceeded the expectations of his governors, the people who were overseeing him. And even today, you know, if we can do all things unto the Lord, an excellent spirit in us will be evident. And Daniel chapter 6 verse 26 in fact tells us that, you know, Daniel was so excellent that at one point the king said that everyone in the land must fear the God of Daniel. You know, is that true of us today? As we fear God and we walk with the fear of God, not just in the midst of believers, but particularly among unbelievers, can people look at us and say, here are people who fear God, who do all things with the fear of God? You know, they wouldn't do anything wrong, anything that is wrong by God. And you know, can those who are above us look at us and tell the, you know, rest of the unbelievers to fear God because of our lives? Let that be our testimony. And if God can do it in the life of Job, if God can do it in the life of Joseph, and he can do it in the life of Daniel, I'm sure us having the Holy Spirit inside us, you know, now we live in a time when the Holy Spirit of God lives on the inside of us. I'm sure that we too can live lives that are excellent as we walk in the fear of the Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we praise you, God, for the life examples of Daniel and Job and Joseph, Father. Lord, the way they did all things with the fear of God, and you gave them, oh Father, an excellent spirit, something that was noticed by everyone. Lord, thank you for your word declares, oh God, that we have got to be salt and light, Father. Lord, that we are a city on a hill. And so, Father, I pray that as believers, that you will enable each one of us to have that excellent spirit and shine, oh God, in the places where you have positioned us. Thank you, God. Thank you that, God, even as we do all things unto you, that, Lord, people will be drawn, Father God, into the kingdom of God. We honor you and we thank you, oh Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.